how did a self-taught maker end up on the journey of making a jazz-based guitar? Well, it all goes back to why I started making content in the first place, and that's my kids. I wanted to show them that they could do anything if they put their mind to it. In that time, I've taught myself CAD, 3D printing, laser cutting, and now CNC. Not being able to afford these types of machines, I've been lucky enough to get hold of broken machines, learning about them, and then fixing them up into an operational state. Fast forward to today, and my kids are all but grown up. And recently, my youngest turned around to me and said,
"Dad, can you make me a bass guitar?"
Not knowing anything about making guitars, I said, "Sure, why not?" Leaning into my experience with CAD, I decided I was going to model the bass guitar in Fusion 360 and then use the CNC to cut it out. I started by searching for some plans online and was able to find a PDF file that showed a Fender style jazz bass, including all the measurements. I used the window snipping tool to take pictures of each view that I was interested in so that I could bring them into Fusion 360 as canvases. Using the body image, I brought that into Fusion 360 as a canvas. Right-clicking the canvas in the project menu system, I'm able to calibrate. Calibrating the image allows me to bring that image into Fusion 360 to the correct dimensions. Once in the calibration mode, I clicked a point on each end of the arrow and then typed in the value for that measurement. Once the body canvas is scaled and positioned in the correct place, I started off by measuring and modeling the pocket that will be used for the neck. Ensuring that this is accurate means that we're in a good position and have some room for error further down the road. I drew a sketch onto that canvas, tracing out the outline of the body using a spline. Continue using the measurements on the sketch, I extruded the body to its correct thickness, before extruding the pockets for the neck, the pickups, and the controls. Next up, I needed to model the arm bevel and the belly cut. This was done by tracing a line where the arm bevel starts, then putting a construction plane in the center point of that line. Drawing an angled sketch, I then able to use that as a projection line for the next operation. From there, I was able to use the sweep tool to then extrude along the path, creating the arm bevel. This process was then repeated on the backside of the body to carve in the belly cut. For aesthetics, I included the fillet just to give it that real feel, but when we come to machine it, we're going to machine it square and then use a roundover bit in a router to give it that soft edge. Now that the model is complete, we go through the process of doing a CNC setup. To do this, I created a new file, brought the body into it, and rotated it in the orientation of my CNC. I'm sure there's a better way of doing this, but I don't know how, and this worked. I set up the stock so that it was the size of the bed, and then went through a series of operations. Because this is a two-sided operation, I machined four registration pins in the surface of my CNC. These will be translated into the stock material when it comes time to actually cut the material. And the reason for this is so when we come to flip it over, we have an accurate registration for when we want to machine the backside so that things line up properly. So the first operation we do is to face the material. And that ensures that it is flat and parallel to the base of the CNC machine. Flipping this over and facing the other side ensures that it is at the correct thickness and everything is parallel. Once the facing operation is completed, we do a bore operation to cut the registration marks into the blank. Next up, we do a 2D adaptive clearing operation to cut out the neck, the pickups, and also the control pockets. To reduce the stress on the machine, the next operation we do is a contour cut, which cuts a series of slots along the arm bevel. We leave approximately 0.5 millimeters of material left so that when we come in with the roundover bit and do the parallel cut, it cuts it nice and smooth. Once that's complete, we flip the material over and do the setup for the backside. The belly cut on the backside is completed initially by a contour cut, again creating that stepped look. We then come in with a parallel cut to smooth it off, and finally a contour cut around the whole of the body to cut it out. With all of those CNC files completed and outputted ready for the CNC machine, it's now time to assemble the blank. Now I'm probably going to be making this base out of either alder or ash. Those materials are quite expensive in my location, so I used some softwood to make up a blank inexpensively so we can test the CNC toolpath, and if it ruins it, then it's not a particularly expensive endeavor. I assembled some softwood pieces and realized that I didn't have enough material to make a full width blank. So I ended up using some OSB as well in here, which kind of gives it a cool look, but is less than ideal in terms of the materials that we're using. Once glued up, I used a makeshift clamping system to bond this all together. The purpose of this is not to be structurally sound, it is there purely to survive the CNC operation so we can tell whether or not our CNC toolpaths have been successful or not. Once that's done, it's time to run the operations themselves. We start with screwing the blank down to the bed, making sure that the screw holes that we're using can be used in future operations. So they need to be outside of the base profile so that the tool doesn't hit them. And they also need to be outside of where the registration pins are going to be. Once the blank is screwed down, we do a surfacing operation before flipping it over using the registration pins that we've just machined. Then we run through our adaptive cuts, our profile cuts, and parallel cuts for the front of the body before flipping it over and repeating it for the belly cut. At the end of this process, I run a router around the edges of the base, and it came out to a finish like this. I'm really happy with how the body of the base has turned out. When it comes time to doing this with either the alder or the ash, we're going to do something a little bit special. This guitar is going to have specific significance to my son, not only for the fact that I've made it, but I'm going to also incorporate some elements from his grandfather, but more about that in another video. If you're interested in knowing how I did the CAD work or the CNC work, have a look at the links in the description below, where I live stream both of these topics end to end. Next up is going to be the most technical part of this build, which is getting the neck right. Making sure that the frets are actually spaced correctly is going to be the difference between a bass guitar that looks great and a bass guitar that plays great. I have no idea whether or not I'm going to be able to pull this off as a playable instrument, but I'm going to give it a damn good try. So if you're interested in following along, why not hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. Damn, it's hot up here. Wah.